everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome all to our Shotsuki Sunday service this morning. So I was watching the news and I saw on the news that December 2nd, which was yesterday, was the 75th anniversary of the birth of the atomic age, which began when Enrico Fermi split an atom at the University of Chicago. So yes, it was the birth of atomic age. And even now, the world lives with atomic power and constantly discusses about how to best use the power. And along with the discussion of use of atomic power, has also come to the problem of the disposal of the radioactive waste. And particularly relevant to this problem was a statement by one of the former presidents of America. And he spoke of how the radioactive waste are buried in deserts or underground in a lot of places in this country. And such an action is possible because America is a huge country, has huge land. But it also reflects how we think about nature in this country. So, how does Buddhism conceive mankind and nature? This question came into my mind, after that former president's speech, because he mentioned how it is often that mankind stands against nature. So it's kind of mankind and nature. It's different. So I'd like to talk about how Buddhism sees the mankind and nature. So the other day I was taking a walk in Berkeley, and as you know, the lake itself is surrounded by beautiful nature, and the leaves are changing their colors. And as I was walking, I saw some guys in a boat fishing. And they were drinking something, maybe a beer, something out of a can. And I was kind of surprised when one of them left the can on the shore when they left. And actually looking around, I didn't realize there were litter all sorts of places. It's relatively clean. Berg Lake is really clean, but there's some spots that has trash. And I also often see trashes, thrown out of the car window. When we're driving, like cigarettes and the candy wraps. And so I kind of thought that those who litter may think that someone will take care of their trash. So maybe it wasn't a big a deal. It didn't matter to them because their mind has the idea that someone will take care of my trash. However, thinking about this further, it occurs to me that they litter because they see themselves as separate from the nature. And this is, I think this is mankind against nature. But Buddhism has the idea of mankind with nature. not against it. And I think many of you have heard the word, you know, middle path. So Siddhartha, the founder of Buddhism, the enlightened one, taught us that it is a mistake to cling too hard on one side or the other of two separated arguments. And rather, he suggested we should balance between the two. And this he called the middle path. The idea of mankind against nature seems to me to clinch on one side of a two-sided path. And it creates a division between mankind and nature. And then it opposes the one to the other. Shinran Shonin, the founder of our denomination of Shin Buddhism, shared his ideas about, you know, mankind and nature in his writings. Shinran's idea was that all things like the air, the sea, animals, plants, even humans, and other natural phenomena exist all together and are interdependent. So, without air, we cannot live, and that's kind of obvious. But plants produce the oxygen in the air, and the water in the rain makes the plants to grow. So, the air and the water nurtures the plants nurtures the animals, and all these things nurtures us. All these things nurtures us. But unfortunately, we tend to separate that, humankind and nature. And Shinran, in one of his writings, he teaches us not to separate ourselves, human, off from animals, plants, and other aspects of nature. We must discover the middle path. Do not separate it. And interdependency makes this possible because when we realize that all nature phenomena are interconnected, as we realize, as we awaken that, you know, everything nurtures us, it becomes impossible to separate them from us. Once we are awakened, it's impossible, and we should not separate it. And this idea of middle path, mankind with nature, actually, it's a really wonderful idea that can help us in our everyday lives. And this, for all of us, should be the purpose of the Dharma, the Buddhist teachings. So please join me in Dasho. By reciting the Nambutsu Namo Amida Butsu, we are always reminded what makes our individual lives even more meaningful. And always reminded the Dharma in times of need. Namo Amida Butsu.
Namo Amida
Butsu. Namo Amida Butsu.
Namo Amida Butsu.
Namo Amida Butsu.